Today we're gonna talk about the last topic in this lecture, in this class, اللي هو another method to design IIR filters. المرة اللي احنا مرة شفنا bilinear transformation method for designing infinite impulse response filters اللي يكون فيهم ال Y, يكون فيهم Y, fast values of Y. Now we're gonna see another method اسمها ال pole zero placement method. So طريقة هذه بنستخدم ال poles والzeros. So we decide what are the poles, what are the zeros. وبناء عليه we can find the transfer function. And then of course if we have a transfer function we will be able to find the difference equation. Okay, so هي الفكرة هي انه we decide the poles, يعني نختار مكان ال pole ومكان ال zeros. And then based on that we can compute the transfer function. So معروف لأنه معروف ال Z transform and location of the poles and zeros they control the magnitude. فهما they control the magnitude of the filter. Location of the pole in particular determines stability. زي ما نعرف إذا كان poles يكونوا داخل circle it's stable. وإذا كان برا circle it is unstable. فنختار دائما poles داخل circle عشان يكون stable. والنمبر اوف زيروز عدد الزيروز ده determines the phase linearity هل هي linear phase ولا مش linear phase فنعرف احنا الاشياء هذه based on these ideas we can decide okay let's put the poles here put the مش عارف الزيروز here بحيث انه يعني يكون عندنا الخصائص هذه we can design the filter خلينا نشوف how it is طبعا فيها lot of math Again, ما أقدر أروح في الماث بروفس وكذا long story ما في وقت لها هنا لكن إحنا حنشوف الطريقة كيف مثلا here is the way to design a band pass filter يعني هذا filter it passes a band of frequencies so شكله يعني تقريبا كده so there is some bands of frequencies to pass. In the past, دائماً كنا نعطي ال low frequency وال high frequency. So F low, F high. هنا this method we cannot give that. So we just design a pass band around some frequency F zero. So نختار ال F zero. وبعدين it's gonna be a passing a band, a narrow band around F zero. ممكن نتحكم في length حق الباند شوية هذه، لكن مش كثير. Anyway, this is the way to design a second order. Second order معناته ال transfer function حقته فيها z squared. So it is a second order. Band pass the function with a narrow pass band around f0. So for this second order narrow band pass filter, we should put the poles inside the circle and the zeros must be here. Zero يكون موجود في النقطة هذه والزيرو الثاني يكون موجود في النقطة هذه. So this is the placement for the poles and zeros for the band pass filter. The transfer function is going to be equal to this form. So هذه الفورم حقتها. There is a parameter k اللي هو عندنا الإيكويشن حقه هنا. Times z minus 1 times z plus 1 over z minus r اللي هو radius حق البول. E to the power of j theta. Theta اللي هي الأنجل حق البول. Times z minus r to the times e to the power of minus j theta. So هنا plus j theta وهنا minus j theta. طبعا if we distributed it will become equal to this. So we had a transfer function based on the placement of the pole and the zeros. طبعا what is r? What is theta? Okay, what is k? K is a scale factor to adjust the band pass filter. So it has a unit pass band gain. So there is a feature that they are interested in. They use the K to control that. Anyway, K formula حقتها just this is the formula. You just use it to compute K based on R and theta. So it controls basically or adjusts the bandpass gain. So طبعا احنا لما يجي يقولوا لنا اوكي ديزاين باند باس فلتر ما يقولوا هاي ار وهاي ثيتا, هم يقولوا اوكي اي وانت فلتر مثلا باسز فريكوينسيز اراوند اف 0, ويعطونا اف 0 هم حقيقه, ذس وات ذي جيف اس اف 0, ويعطونا ايضا السامبلينج فريكوينسي لانه احنا ذس از ا فيري امبورتنت فيتشر او بارامتر اللي هو السامبلينج فريكوينسي اف اس, لانه فور ديجيتال سيستم وي نيد وات از ذا سامبلينج الفريكوينسي اللي انت عملتها اللي هي سامبل, سو اف اس لانه هذه هي الليمت حق frequency content. حسب Nyquist theorem, إذا أنت سويت sampling with FS, خلاص يعني maximum frequency عندك في في signal هي FS over 2. So we need to know FS. So هم لما يقول لك design a filter, band pass filter, ما يعطوك ال R و theta, هم يعطوك ال F0, يقول لك I wanted to pass frequencies around F0, وبعدين I will give you the sampling frequency. فطبعاً this method, in this method you have to define, you have to compute what is R, what is theta, based on the requirements اللي هم عطوك إياه. وفيها math, well, this is the equation at the end. طبعاً R is approximately, this is an approximation for R, it's 1 minus VW, which is the bandwidth اللي نبغاه هنا, in decibel, over FS, times pi. And this is approximation only good for R between 0.9 to 1. يعني تكون قريبة من السيركل. تكون قريبة من السيركل. With theta is F0 over sampling frequency FS times 360 degrees. Well, just to convert the theta into degrees. لك ما يحتاج هذه. إذا تبغاها radians, just keep it this way. أضربها في pi, I guess, or 2 pi. بدل 360 degrees, you're going to multiply in 2 pi if you want it to be in radians. So once you have r and theta, you can compute k. تحتاج r and theta. But then you can compute the transfer function. Once you have the transfer function, خلاص, you can get the difference equation. So بالنسبة لنا, فيها a lot of math, but we're not going to go through it. لكن بالنسبة لنا it's just a matter of algebra to compute things بس يعني حط في الكالكوليتر وحسب فايتس it's an easy kind of task بالنسبة لنا. Yeah, so the zeros are placed on the unit circle. So for a this is now a band stop filter, okay? This is the way the equations for the band pass filter. For the band stop filter, يعني العكس, يعني هو it stops frequencies around F0. So it's not pass band, I'm sorry, it's pass stop on F0. So in this case, the zeros are placed on the unit circle with the same angle with respect to the poles. So for the band stop filter, the zeros كانوا هنا for the band pass. Now for the band stop, they have to be here, aligned with the poles. Aligned with the poles. And in that case, R is equal to this equation, 1 minus bandwidth WW over FS times pi. And again, it's good for R close to the circle. With theta is F0 over FS times 360 degrees. And this is the equation of the transfer function. So it's different. And I can't give z minus 1 times z plus 1. Now we have e to the power of j theta and e to the power of minus j theta. Okay, this is the formula for k, the scale factor. Let's look at an example. So here is the example. So we have a sampling rate of 8,000 hertz. The bandwidth BW at 3 decibels, 100 hertz. So this is basically the length of the band pass. It's narrow, And so we want it centered to at f0, 1500 hertz, with the bandwidth or width of the band 100 hertz. So this is what you are given. And you need to compute the band pass filter. So we can use the formulas. هاي الفورمولا موجودة هنا أنا حاطها هنا. So this is the formula for R. This is the formula for theta. ننزل هذه تحت. نحط theta هنا. This is the scale factor. Okay, so we use the formula. We can compute R. Is 1 minus the bandwidth 100 over 8000 times pi. So just a calculator, it becomes 0.9607. بالنسبة للثيتا, it is 1500 f0 over f sampling frequency times 360. So this is 67 degrees, the angle in degrees. And بالنسبة للk, this is the equation for k. So it is 1 minus 2 times, we just computed R, cosine the angle, plus R squared, over 2 minus 2 cosine theta. So we just do the calculation, tetla 0.962. And based on that, we can compute the transfer function. The equation I get that. Okay, so this is the K, Z squared, minus 2Z cosine theta, plus 1, over Z squared minus 2 times R, Z cosine the angle theta, plus R squared. And then you just do your calculations. This becomes, you get this. After you do the calculations, you divide by Z squared on top of the top. عشان نخليها Z to the power minus 2. ليش؟ لأنه بعدين هذا لما نحولها difference equation, Z to the power of minus a negative power, هذه becomes a shift. فنبغاها negative power. So خلاص, once you have the transfer function, this is your filter. This, you can find the difference equation. Okay, this is your filter. طبعا this is a not a يعني ما تقدر هنا تتحكم يعني زي ما قلنا, it's a narrow, it's only for narrow band, narrow pass band filter. لأنه I think a mistake here was not pass band, it's pass. It's band stop. صح? We're doing the band stop again. So, some mistakes. That's band stop. No, stop the band. It's basically following these equations. So, it is a band stop band, not pass band. So الفلتر يعني it's narrow band, يعني it's only available, these approximations, هذه الapproximations تشتغل فقط for narrow band, يعني ما تقدر تسوي pass band كبيرة لأنه هذه الapproximation تصير غلط. You cannot use this approximation, البول حقتها يصير بعيد عن السيركل. But it's a method, يعني it's there. You can also use it for low pass filter و high pass filter. So for a low pass filter, عندنا طبعا الكاتوف فريكونسي, بس في عندنا حالتين, two cases. إذا الكاتوف فريكونسي أقل من fourth sampling frequency, لأنه حنعرف طبعا دائما زي ما قلنا الكونتنت الفريكونسي كونتنت حق السيجنال حيكون محدود ب fs over 2. خلاص السيجنال sampled signal ما فيها frequencies أكثر من fs over 2, so this is the maximum. ف fs over 4 هو هنا في النص بالضبط. إذا الكاتوف فريكونسي أقل من النص, الأبروكسيميشن حقت ألفا اللي هي مكان البول يساوي 1 minus 2 times fs over fc كاتوف فريكونسي over sampling times pi. لكن لما تكون fc كاتوف فريكونسي above الربع هنا في المنطقة هذه, لكن الإكويجن هذه تطلع غلط, يعني الأبروكسيميشن غلط, تصير different, الأبروكسيميشن تصير minus 1 minus pi plus 2 times fc cut off frequency over s times pi. So حسب البروبلم اذا اعطاك الكت اوف فريكوانسي لازم تشوف هل هو في النصف الاولاني هذا او النصف الثاني, هل هو above اقل من fs over 4 او اكثر من fs over 4, لانه في عندنا two different approximations. Then after getting the alpha, the transfer function is simply k times z plus 1 over z minus alpha. بعد ما نحسب الالفا, we can find the transfer function where the scaling factor is 1 minus alpha over 2. So computation is أسهل. We can also do it for a here's an example. Suppose you're given a sampling rate of 8000 hertz. Well, 3 decibel cutoff frequency of 100 hertz. So هنا هل هي أقل من الربع ولا أكثر من الربع؟ Well, fs over 2 هي 4000, fs over 4 هي 2000. فالcutoff frequency 100 هي أقل من 2000. فنستخدم إذن الapproximation الأولى هذه. 1 minus 2, 100 على 8000 times pi. So this becomes 0.9215. And then we can find the transfer function. الk ما حسبنا الk. So we compute the k based on the formula. 1 minus alpha. نحط alpha first. So 1 minus alpha اللي حسبناها هنا over 2. And then we have the transfer function. And then we divide by z. من فوق ومن تحت عشان we have to get a z to the power of minus 1. So once you have this transfer function, you can, using the inverse z transform, طلع difference equation. And that's your filter. Pretty easy to apply if you have the equations, يعني مجرد algebra to compute the filters. Finally, we can also use this for a high pass filter. When the cutoff frequency is less than, نفس الشيء عندنا حالتين. When the cutoff frequency أقل من الربع fs over 4 أو أقل من أو أكثر من ربع f sampling frequency, then we have two different approximations for alpha. في الحالة هذه الزيرو has to be here on the x-axis for a high pass filter. Zero has to be on the x-axis, and alpha can be here or here. So if the cutoff frequency أقل من الربع من ربع الفري sampling frequency, then alpha will be in this range, 1 minus 2 fc over s times pi. And if fc is bigger than sampling frequency over 4, then it will be in this range, minus, it will be negative. And this is the formula for it. And once we have that, we can compute k. He won plus alpha over 2. And then based on that, we can compute the transfer function. K times z minus 1 over z minus alpha. So if you are given the cutoff frequency with sampling frequency, you can always do these computations and find the high pass filter. Any questions?
واضح إن شاء الله دكتور.